Because when you try to avoid the inevitable, it's going to happen anyway. So you might as well have a plan for it than trying to avoid it. All right, let's talk a little bit about binge eating. A lot of times binge eating has to do with over-restricting foods that you otherwise think you can't eat. So the best way to avoid this type of binge eating is to allow yourself to eat the foods that you don't think you should be eating. One of the things that I do for myself and I recommend to clients is instead of saying, I can only eat this on Saturdays or I can only eat this, you know, once in a blue moon, allow yourself to have a couple of times during the week where you have a very controlled portion of said food. For me personally, that's chocolate. Instead of reserving a chocolate bar for the end of the week where I'm more likely to build up a lot of restrictive behavior and a lot of scarcity mindset, what I do is a couple of times a week when I need it or when I want it, I have one square of chocolate. And by having multiple opportunities where I'm okay with having that square of chocolate and I fit it in my calories, I'm much less likely that at the end of the week on a Friday or a Saturday to eat the entire chocolate bar. This is another reason why I don't like the idea of cheat days. Now, when it comes to emotional eating and stress eating, I'd be lying if I said I was perfect with this. This is just advice that I try to follow. I don't always do very well at it. And sometimes stress eating just happens. And instead of feeling guilty about that, I just accept it and learn from the experience and I get better and better as I go. And you should do the exact same thing. If I'm eating to relieve stress, the first thing I do is I like to acknowledge that that's actually what's going on. Because the first step to anything is awareness. After that, I tell myself, okay, I'm going to have a healthy dinner or the best possible healthy dinner I can for this particular day. And then afterwards, if I want something to snack on when I'm watching The Sopranos or I'm watching The Mandalorian, which are my two favorite shows right now, I will pick popcorn or fruit. Now, the reason I pick popcorn is because it's crunchy and it's salty and it's pretty much low calories for the most part. The reason I pick fruit is because it's something sweet that can help curb my sweet cravings, but also being a high volume type of food. So if I have these foods in the house, I have go-to snacks for when I want to sort of eat for fun. Now, I'm certainly not saying that these are the only foods you can eat when you're binge eating to, you know, somehow reduce the amount of calories you're consuming. But my point is that I have a strategy for when that happens. If I just have bags of tortilla chips in my house, this strategy wouldn't work. So my personal method that I think works really well is having a plan for what happens when a situation occurs instead of trying to avoid the situation altogether. Because when you try to avoid the inevitable, it's going to happen anyway. So you might as well have a plan for it than trying to avoid it. This has been another Coffee Talk. Thank you.